Hello students, in this video we will study about the 8253 or 8254 programmable interval timer, its functional block diagram, pin details and six operating modes. So let us start our topic. The difference between 8253 and 8254 is 8253 uses NMOS technology and does not support read back command, whereas 8254 works on HMOS technology and support read back command. Then 8253 is not possible to generate accurate time delay using delay routines in 8086 processor. 8254 is possible to generate accurate time delays, minimizes load on microprocessor, real-time clock, even counter, digital one-shot, square wave generator, complex waveform generator. So these are the facilities available in case of 8254. The next difference is 8253 has an operating frequency of 0 to 2.6 MHz, whereas 8254 its operating frequency that ranges between 0 to 10 MHz. The last difference being that whereas in 8253, the read and write command of the same counter cannot be interwoven together. In 8254, it is possible to interweave the read and write command of the same counter. So these are the difference between 8253 and 8254 programmable interval timer. So this is the pin diagram of 8253. The next diagram, signal configuration of 8253. So this is pin details of 8254. The next one is functional block diagram of 8254 programmable interval timer. Counter is functionally similar to the software design timer and counters. 8254 is a 24 pin DIP IC and requires a single plus 5 volt power supply. The pin diagram of 8254 is shown here. The functional block diagram of 8254 is shown here. It consists of three counters, counter 0, counter 1 and counter 2, in addition with data bus buffer, read write control logic and control word register. Let's see the pin details of 8254. Pin number 128 indicates D0 to D7, that is bidirectional 3 state data bus lines connected to the system data bus. Then pin number 9, clock 0, that is clock input of counter 0. Then pin number 10, output of counter 0. Pin number 11, gate input of counter 0. Then pin number 12, act as ground signal. Then pin number 13, output of counter 1. Then pin number 14, gate input of counter 1. Then pin number 15, clock input of counter 1. Pin number 16, gate input of counter 2. Pin number 17, output of counter 2. Then pin number 18, clock input of counter 2. Then pin number 19 and 20, that is A1 and A0. Okay, this is nothing but address. A0 and A1 is nothing but address. This address is used to select one of the three counters or the control word register for read and write operation. Normally, it is connected to the system address bus. A1 and A0, both values are 0. Counter 0 is selected. Then A1 0, A0 value 1. Counter 1 is selected. then A1 is equal to 1, A0 is equal to 0, counter 2 is selected, then A1, A0, both values are equal to 1, that time control word is selected. Okay, then pin number 21, CS, chip select signal, yellow on this input enables the 8254 to respond read signal or write signal. Read and write or ignored otherwise. Okay, if it is a high, read and write are ignored. Then pin number 22, read signal. This input is low during CPU read operation. Then pin number 23, write signal. This input is low during CPU write operation. Then pin number 24, act as plus 5 volt power supply. So 8254 is a 24 pin DIP IC chip. It requires plus 5 volt power supply. The next one, functional block diagram of 8254. The first block, data bus buffer. The data bus buffer is a tri-state bidirectional 8-bit buffer. It is connected to the data bus of the microprocessor. Data is transmitted or received by the buffer upon execution of in and out instruction by the microprocessor. Second one, control logic. The control logic has 5 signals. The first one, read signal. Second one, write signal. Third one, CS signal. 4 and 5, that is A0 and A1. This section accepts input from system bus and in turn generates control signals for overall device operation. Third block, control word register. A control word is written into this register, which specifies the counter to be used, its mode, and either a read or write operation. However, the control word register is not available for a read operation. Okay, then counters, 8254 has 3 identical counters, counter 0, counter 1 and counter 2. Each counter is a 16-bit resettable down counter which can operate in either binary or BCD counter. They can operate independently in any one of the 6 operating modes. They are mode 0, interrupt on terminal couch, mode 1, programmable one shot, mode 2, rate generator, mode 3, square wave generator, mode 4, software triggered mode, and last one is hardware triggered mode. See, read write control logic, CS signal active or slow means the 8254 is selected for operation. If the signal goes high, the 8254 is not selected for operation. That is the meaning. Okay. Then this is also, that is a read signal also, active or slow signal. If it is a high means there is no read operation. If it is low, read operation be done. Then write operation. This is also active or slow signal. If the signal goes low, write operation. If the signal goes high, there is no write operation. Already you know A0 and A1 is used for counter selection. So for 00 condition, counter 0 is selected. 01 condition, counter 1 is selected. 10 condition, counter 2 is selected. 11 condition, control word is selected. Okay, here write signal active or slow. So write counter 0, write counter 1, write counter 2, write control register. Okay, then next combination, again 00, counter 0 is selected, 01, counter 1 is selected, 10, counter 2 is selected. See, for these 3 conditions, the write signal active was high, but the read signal active was low. So read counter 0, read counter 1, read counted 2. Then next combination, see here, both values are high, that is A0, A1, both are high. Here write operation high, but read operation value is 0. That time no operation, that is tri-stated. Tri-stated means that is high impedance state, that is no connection between input and output, that is called tri-stated. The next combination 0, 1, 1, whatever may be A0 and A1 value. In that condition also no operation, tri-stated. Last condition, see a signal value is high. The remaining signal, whatever may be, but the 8254 is not selected for operation. Then control word format. So this is the control word format of 8254. It is a 8-bit register. D0th bit, the 8254 can be operated in either binary or BCD operation. Okay, if the bit value is equal to 0, binary counter 16 bits. Suppose bit value, that is a D0 is equal to 1, binary code a decimal, that is a BCD counter. Okay, so D0 bit value equal to 0 means binary operation. If the bit value is equal to 1 indicates BCD operation. Okay, then the next 3 bits, D1, D2 and D3, it is nothing but select the mode. Already you know 8254 can be operated in 6 operating modes. All values are 0, that is 0, 0, 0, mode 0 is selected. So mode 0 is nothing but interrupt on terminal count. 0, 0, 1, mode 1 is selected. Mode 1 is nothing but programmable one shot. Then 1, 0 combination, mode 2 is selected, that is rate generator. Then 1, 1 combination, mode 3 is selected, that is square wave generator. 100, that is software triggered mode. Mode 4 is nothing but software triggered mode. Then 101, that is mode 5. Mode 5 is nothing but hardware triggered stroke. So D1, D2 and D3 is used for mode selection. Okay, then D4 and D5, read or write operation. If both values are 00, counter latch operation. 01, read operation or write operation, least significant byte only. 10 combination, read or write operation, most significant byte only. 11, read or write operation, least significant byte first, then most significant byte. Okay, then D6 and D7. So D6 and D7, select counter. So both values are 00, counter 0 is selected. 01 combination, counter 1 is selected. 10 combination, counter 2 is selected. 11 combination, read back command signal. So this is about control word format of 8254. So these are the operating modes. Already you know 8254 can operate independently in any one of the 6 operating modes. That is mode 0, interrupt on terminal count, mode 1, programmable one shot, mode 2, rate generator, mode 3, square wave generator, mode 4, software triggered mode, then mode 5, hardware triggered mode or strobe. See, the first mode, that is mode 0, interrupt on terminal count. In mode 0, the gate is held high, so that the counter is always enabled. Initially the output is high. When the control word is loaded into the control word register, the output becomes low. Okay, once the count value is loaded into the counter register, then the output becomes low. That is, the count is loaded into the counter register. In the next clock pulse, the count is transferred from the count register to the actual counter. Each clock pulse after this will decrement the count by 1. When the counter reaches 0, the output will go high. If a count n is loaded into the counter in mode 0, the output will go high after n plus 1 clock pulses. This output can be used to interrupt the microprocessor. So here in this diagram, count value is 7. Initially the output is high. Once the count value is loaded into the counter register, then the next clock pulse, the counter decrement operation starts. So that time the output value is low. When the counter reaches 0, then again the output value is high. Okay, so this mode can be used to interrupt the microprocessor. Then mode 1. In mode 1, the gate is initially held low. The output will be high. The count is loaded into the count register. Then the gate is made high. The rising edge of the gate input transfer the count from the count register to the actual counter. Then the output becomes low and the countdown begins. When the terminal count is reached, the output becomes high. Okay, so this is about mode 1. Your count value 5. Initially the gate signal is low. The output signal is high. Once the count value loaded into the counter register, then countdown starts. Okay. At the end of terminal count, the output goes high. So this is mode 1. Then mode 2, rate generator. In this mode, the 8254 becomes a divide by n counter. In this mode, the gate is held high. The output will be normally high. When the count is loaded into the counter, the countdown begins. When the count reaches 1, the output will go low. The falling edge of the next clock pulse will cause the output to go high again. Then the original count will be reloaded again and the process will repeat. If the counter is loaded with a number n, the output pin will go low for one clock cycle in every n input clock pulses. The frequency of the output waveform will be equal to the input clock frequency divided by n. So this is rate generator. The next one, mode 3, that is square wave generator. In mode 3, the output will be square wave. The frequency of the square wave will be equal to the clock frequency divided by the number of written into the count register. If the count is an even number, the output will be high for half the count and low for the half the count. And the output waveform will be symmetrical. If the count is odd, the output will be high for n plus 1 divided by 2 count and low for n minus 1 divided by 2 count. So the output waveform will not be symmetrical. So this is square wave. Then mode 4, software triggered strobe. In mode 4, the gate is held high. When the count is loaded into the counter, the countdown begins. When the terminal count, that is 0, is reached, the output goes low for one clock period and goes high again. So this is about software triggered mode. Next one, hardware triggered strobe. In mode 5, the gate is initially held low and the count is loaded into the count register. Then the gate is made high. The rising edge of the gate input loads the count into the counter and the countdown begins. When the terminal count, that is 0, is reached, the output goes low for one clock period and goes high again. So this is hardware triggered mode. So these are the details of 8254 programmable interval timer. I hope this video is useful. Soon we will meet in the next video. Thank you.